11 13. We will connect and the bus will stay here for us. Now you can help me to go on the middle of the bridge over there and take some picture. I will go and buy ticket. We need a ticket to come inside the Hoa Lư Temple. Thank you. You can wait me at the bridge over there and take some picture. Thank you.
Picture, come out, take the picture.
Parking the bikes here. 5 minutes. Yeah, just 5 minutes only. Everyone remember the bikes. Yes, sir. Yeah, easy for everyone to remember. Yeah, yeah. Because sometimes we have a number. Sometimes we have a number, but sometimes no number. Yeah. We wait me about 5 minutes. Yeah, because I need a time to buy tickets over there. After that, we need to buy go inside.
Một, hai, ba, rửa đi ạ. Một, So for Luca team, please follow me and we will go inside. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, in front of us, this is the Huanu Temple, and this one is the park. This is the capital of Vietnam from the year 1968 until 1999. And you can see that in here, it has three ways to go inside. At the middle, this one is the visiting area, and this one is being used for the VIP. It is a suite for the Queen or royal family member. On the right side, it will be in on the shoulder of the general. In Vietnam, we said that general, they are the right hand of the king. They will help the king to protect the kingdom. Yeah. And for the normal people, we go for the left side. So now, if you want to become king and queen, you can help me choose the middle way. If you want to become shoulder, you can choose the right way. And normal people go for the left way. It depends on you. Yeah. Okay. So I'm just kidding. Now we can only go for the right side. Only go for the right side. I will give you a ticket and please help me to keep the ticket one by one. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, I love the window. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, you know that in the past, Vietnam, we have been under control by China for nearly 1,000 years. And in the past, we have the peak. So in here, we have the picture of the king, and he is the first king of Vietnam. The first king. So for the name of him, this is Đinh Bộ Lĩnh. Đinh Bộ Lĩnh, he is the first king of Vietnam. He claimed the independence and autonomy for Vietnam country. After he became the king, he chose this area to become the capital for two reasons. The first reason, this one is his hometown. He was born in Ninh Bình province. And the second reason, this one will have the meaning for defense. You can see that in front we have a river. So if the China, they want to attack the capital, they have to swim across the river. And after that, they will feel exhausted. No more energy for fighting. Also, surround this area, we have a lot of mountain, limestone mountain. So it will take a lot of energy for the hiking and also for attack the city. That's why this one will have the meaning for defense, yeah. And we will go down there, I will show you down there. So ladies and gentlemen, you can see that in here we have the picture, and this one is like the boat trip on the river. In the past, at the year 1009, we have a new king, and for the new king, he saw that this area is not suitable for Vietnam to develop the economy. That's why he decided to move the capital from Ninh Bình to Hà Nội nowadays. And nowadays, Hà Nội becomes the capital more than 1,000 years. So this picture describes about the trip that we move the capital from Ninh Bình to Hà Nội. Now you can help me to take a look for the temple over there, for the temple. So for the temple, this one we read the temple in the 100,000 Vietnam đồng. Anyone you have 100, okay, can help me borrow it? 100,000 Vietnam đồng. Maybe you can help me to check for the wallet. I don't have 100 today. It has the green color. If you have it, 100,000 Vietnam đồng, green color. Oh yeah. Thank you. So here I have the 100, and you can see the temple in this money. This is the same temple over there. So this one, this is the temple of literature. And this one nowadays located in Hà Nội City. We consider the temple of literature is like the first university of Vietnam. And Vietnam, we believe that if you can graduate a good university, maybe in the future you can earn a lot of money. That's why we choose to bring the temple of literature in the Vietnamese money to encourage everyone to study well, and hope that we can make a lot of money in the future. This is the reason. So maybe after the Ninh Bình trip, if you have time, you can book a city tour and you will go there. It has the name Văn Miếu Quốc Tử Giám, the temple of literature, and you can take a picture with this one on the building. So now you can help me to go down there, and we will visit the temple. Please help me to go down there and wait down there 1 minute. I have some people missing. I will come back and check for them. Thank you.
Cô chú ơi, con xin phép là chắc là ở trong đền thì con sẽ dùng tiếng Anh, sau đó thì lên xe thì con sẽ gửi cho mình thông tin tiếng Việt sau. So ladies and gentlemen, you can see that in here we have the basket that inside we have some clothes. This one will be used for some ladies. If you wear a skirt or maybe a short, that shorter that you need. Because in Vietnam we have one rule except for the lady that you need to cover for your leg when you go inside the temple. But today, I think that a lot of people inside, so we don't have enough clothes for today. So we should get knocked down before our food. Yeah. So now we will go inside the temple and we will spend to visit the temple inside of the temple. So ladies and gentlemen, in here we have the statue of animal, and this one in Vietnam we call the name unicorn. For the unicorn in Vietnam, it will have the head of the lion. It has the body of the dog. And at the back, it will have the small tail, look like the snake tail. So it will be the unicorn in Vietnam. Head of lion, body of the dog, and tail of the snake. And this one in Vietnam is being put outside the temple of pagoda. It will be used to prevent the evil thing. So inside the temple, we worship for the king, and the king in Vietnam is going to be dragon. So inside, the dragon stay inside, and unicorn stay outside, protect the dragon. This is the meaning why we put the unicorn over here. And also, you can take a look behind you. We have the dragon bed. You can see the name over there, dragon bed. For the dragon bed, this one is made by stone. You know that Vietnam, we are the tropical country and we are very hot in summer. That's why in the past, we will sleep in the stone, so it will be cooler on the back. For the dragon bed before, it will be used for the king. He will sit here and he will work with the mandarin inside the royal. And after his work, he used this one to sleep. That's why we call dragon bed. It means the bed for dragon. the back of the king. At the middle of the stone, you can see the image of the dragon. This is the image of dragon. But because this one located outside and affected by the sun and the rain, that's why nowadays we cannot see the dragon very clearly like before. Yeah. So now we will go to the second area.
That's my bad guess.
And the king would die by poison. So that's why.
Yeah.
People grow up for them to die here.
Ở đó thì mình làm dạng như kiểu là một cái đồ như kiểu
trưng bày
ạ, trưng bày hợp.
Ngoài ra hiện nay thì cái rừng đó mình sẽ được dùng để trong cái việc là mình
ở cái đền Hoa Lư này sẽ có một cái ngày là ngày đại lễ như kiểu là ngày sinh nhật của vua. Thì cái ngày đó thì mình sẽ có những cái lễ như kiểu là cái đồ lợn hoặc là xôi rồi gà mình đặt lên trên cái đó. Thì nó gọi là ngày xưa thì công dụng của nó là để vua ngồi làm việc với các quan cũng như là để ngủ. Tuy nhiên là ngày nay thì được dùng là để làm trong ngày lễ lớn để mình để đồ lễ. So, ladies and gentlemen, this one is the second area of the temple. And you can see that in here we have the water lake for both sides. So, water in Vietnam is will be represented for the money. Money. This is the door of the temple. When you open the door, the water, the money will flow inside. Yeah. This is the meaning of the water here. Also, you can see that over there we have a lot of fish. Fish. And this is a koi fish. For the color of the fish, it will be yellow or orange color. And this is the color of the gold. Color of the gold, also related to the money. And you can see over there, we have the flag. This one will have five color and represent for five element in Vietnam. Five element. For the red color, it will be fire. Red is fire. The next one is yellow color. Yellow is the color of the ground. It means that represent for the earth. Represent for the earth. The next one is blue color. Blue is going to be sky or maybe water. Represent for water. The next is white color. So some country like China or Singapore, they believe that the white color is going to be represent for the air that we breathe every day. The air. But in Vietnam, we believe that the white color, this is the color of iron. Iron. You know the movie Iron Man? Iron Man, yeah. The color of iron. It means that white color represents for metal. Metal. And the last one is the green color. It's going to be the tree or the flower. So in Vietnam, every people, we will have the different element. For example, I was born in 1995. And my element is fire. It means the red color. And my mom always tell me, do not marry the lady that has water. Because you know, water will destroy fire. But unlucky for me now, because now my wife is water. My wife is water, unlucky for me. Also, you can see in front of us, we have the tree. And this tree in Vietnam is going to be used to create the chopstick to grab the food. The special about this chopstick, it can recognize the poison inside the food. When you use the chopstick, you put it inside the food that has poison. The color of chopstick will change from white color to black color. And when you saw the black color, you know that the food is not good. And you have to change the food for the VIP, for the king, for the queen, for royal family member. Kim Giang chopstick, this is the name of the chopstick. Kim Giang chopstick, yeah. And also, when you go to the temple, you can see a lot of high steps. For the high step here, we build this one for two reasons. the first reason, when you cross the high step, if you don't want to be stumbled, you need to watch the head down. And when you watch the head down, it's like you show respect with the king inside the temple. And also for the high step, it will be used to prevent the animal like dog, like cat, like buffalo. We believe that animal is not allowed to come inside the pagoda or temple. That's why we have the high step in every temple and pagoda in the north of Vietnam. Yeah. So now we will come inside for the last one. So, ladies and gentlemen, this one is the last area of the temple. And later, when you go inside, you can help me to spend 10 minutes for taking picture and take a look inside. Inside the temple, when you go, you can pray. You can pray for the safety, for the lucky, or for long life. But please help me, don't pray for the money. Yeah, because in Vietnam, we believe that money, you have to earn it by yourself, not like pray God or Buddha for the money. Also, when you go there, you can see that at the middle of the jar, we will have the incense burner. So in Vietnam, after we pray, we will burn the incense, and we put the incense into the incense burner. We believe that our prayer is going to follow the smoke of the incense and go up to the sky. Maybe go to God, go to Buddha, and our prayer can become true in the future. This is the meaning of incense in Vietnam. Yeah. So now you can help me to spend like 10 minutes to go inside and taking picture. Now it's like 11:10. Please help me to come back here 11:20. Thank you. If you want to take a picture of the good background over there, you can let me know so that I will help you to take a picture. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good to what? But everyone about the food.
Everyone about the food in the temple of Pagoda.
Yeah.
The temple and Pagoda.